My name is Trenyce. I'm a professional singer and the owner of Glam Entertainment.
Looks fantastic tonight from the movie The Bodyguard. Make way, Whitney, with I Have Nothing. Here is Trenyce.
I was 2 years old, according to my parents, when they first started realizing that I could sing jingles off the radio. Like, I would know every melody, every single lyric. You know, it wasn't like 2 years old, and you know how some two-year-olds, they kind of just hum or like fiddle through the words or whatever. My mom was like, you were very precise at two. You may not have been able to talk or know exactly what those words were, but they were very clear, and she was adamant about that. I had the passion and the drive to be an artist at such a young age when I didn't even know what I was doing. And my mom would come knock on my door and be like, what are you doing? I was like, oh, I made a new song. Let me perform it for you. So, you know, from there, it goes from performing it for your parents to performing it from your parents' friends. And when I was about 13, I started dancing as well. So me and my friends in junior high school, we ended up performing for pep rallies. And so this one particular year, they asked us to sing for our coronation. And they gave out solos, and they were like, Trenyce can sing Whitney Houston. I believe the children are our future. That's what I'm saying, right? And my teachers, because I was so quiet in school, let me just say this, I was never the talkative one, but when I performed, I performed. And so people were kind of like, you mean the quiet girl? So by the time I was singing Whitney Houston, everyone in the school just called me Little Whitney. I was no longer Sean, you know, I was no longer Trenyce, I was Little Whitney Houston. And they always wanted me to sing Whitney Houston no matter what. I felt like I finally had a voice. You know, when you sing other people's music for a long period of time, when you're growing up, and then you finally get that one person where you go, I connect with this person. That's what happened to me when I was 13. I think it's very, very, very important to say that I was by no means where I should have been going up into Idol. I got really nervous because the song that I picked to sing, which was I'll Always Love You, I wasn't able to sing simply because with all of the going back and forth and the stress of it all, my voice went. So my mother was like, just sing, I learned from the best. I was like, okay, because it was low enough, you know, for me to still be able to sing it, but I didn't have to try to hit a high note and croak and all of that. So I sang I Learned from the Best. All of the judges thought I sounded great, and I got through to the next round. And that's when I started realizing that nothing is just by chance. Everything happens for a reason. It was meant for me to go to American Idol. It was meant for me to get fired, because that was my fuel for staying on the show.
Trenyce, you have the most amazing, amazing stage presence. You look beautiful tonight.
Thank you.
You really know how to work that microphone and that stage. It's as if you've been born to do what you are doing right now on that stage.
The one thing that I learned in all of this was to be prepared. As long as you are prepared, all of the other things that come in life, you know, all of the hiccups, it doesn't matter. You just have to be ready when the time comes. When your audition in life comes up, you just have to be ready. I have been very, 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 very blessed to still be working after 10 years of being on American Idol. And remaining relevant is difficult for anyone. It doesn't have to be just American Idol. It's just hard. That's why I know, you know, it's just a blessing to continue working, and I'm not even near where I want to be, you know, as an artist, as a, you know, as a performer. There's so many other things that I want to do, but what I can say is that the things that I've accomplished, being nominated for a Grammy, going overseas to London and being the lead in a Michael Jackson tribute show that, you know, people that his fans, I mean all of his fans, go to, and they go to regularly. It's not just like, you know, one-off, like for some shows. These people are avid fans, so there's constant audience members out there pushing you and pushing you because they want that MJ thing. And then there's the BET show that I did, Love in the Nick of Time, working with Morris Chestnut, and most recently, one of my biggest accomplishments is being able to do my first feature film with Jim Carrey. That to me, it's greater than great. It's better than best because it reminds me constantly that you're always in your moment. It's never over. If you constantly work hard, if you're pushing, if you're auditioning like you're supposed to be, you don't want to be one of those people that become jaded. And it's very easy to do. If you're not constantly saying to yourself, oh, I haven't gotten there yet, you know? It's not about the yet part. It's about you being happy about where you are and just constantly moving.
She looks fantastic tonight from the movie The Bodyguard. Meg Way Whitney with I Have Nothing. Here is Trenyce.
Really need to look very much further. I don't wanna have to go.